In the last video, I demonstrated how to determine if an external memory card is needed, which microSD cards are compatible with Campbell Scientific data loggers, and which CR Basic instructions to use to write data to a card. In this video, I will show how to deploy a microSD card, monitor card status, and swap cards in the field. Remember that to avoid data loss, it is important to use only industrial-rated microSD cards with Campbell Scientific data loggers. The best practice is to use cards purchased from Campbell Scientific to ensure compatibility with the data logger. It's important to protect microSD cards from being damaged. When transporting cards, use a card-carrying case or an ESD envelope to keep the card from being scratched or damaged. Scratches or other damage on the card traces or nicks along the edge of the card may render the card unusable. Before deploying an external memory card, it is a good idea to start with a freshly formatted card. The data logger accepts microSD cards formatted as FAT32. There are several ways to format cards, such as using File Control, SCR1000KD, or Windows. Formatting a card with File Control in the data logger before running a program ensures the card is formatted correctly. To do this, open File Control, then select the CRD drive and select Format. When inserting a card into the data logger, an image on the data logger indicates which direction the card should face when inserted. Anytime a card is inserted into the data logger, the ACT LED should light solid red for at least 1 second. This indicates the card is recognized by the data logger. If there is no red flash when the card is inserted, this indicates the card is not recognized by the data logger. If this occurs, check that the card is compatible with the data logger, undamaged, and that it is formatted correctly. A card may be inserted before or after a program is running. Either way, before the data logger begins storing data to a card, it must first pre-allocate memory on the card. Card memory allocation is indicated by a solid red LED. Depending on the card size and the program, memory allocation may occur almost immediately, or it may take several seconds. Before leaving the field site, make sure the ACT LED is not orange. Solid orange indicates there's an error and that no data is being written to the card. When deploying a microSD card, it is useful to have a laptop or a CR1000KD to verify the card is working correctly before leaving the station in the field. With a CR1000X-KD, from the main menu go to Ports and Status. Select Status Table and use the page down arrow until the card status field is visible. Card status should show Card OK. If I don't have a KD, I can connect to the data logger with a laptop and then go to File Control in LoggerNet or PC400 and verify the CRD drive is present and that the expected data file is present. For this example, I am using the CR Basic instruction cardOut to store data to a card. By default, cardOut files are named following this convention: station name dot table name dot dat. By default, the station name is the data logger serial number. Here I see my data logger serial number, and the name of the table being stored to the card is vwhourly.dat. Because cardOut pre-allocates the final storage memory, the file size shown in File Control is the amount of memory that has been pre-allocated for the file. In this case, I'm using a 2GB card, and my program has one auto-allocated data table. So nearly all the available 2GB of memory has been pre-allocated for this one file, and there are only about 50KB free. Now, look what happens when I replace the 2GB card with a 16GB card while running the same program. I push the eject button, wait for the LED to turn green, and then swap the cards. I will talk about the eject button more in a moment, but anytime I remove a card from the data logger, it is important to push the eject button and wait for the LED to turn green before removing the card. Otherwise, data on the card may be corrupted or the card could be damaged. Now, when I look at File Control, I see the VW hourly table is still about 2GB, but there are about 14GB free on the card. This is because the maximum file size for any single file on a data logger is 2GB. To use all 16GB available on the card for this one table, I need to use table file to write many smaller files from the same table. In this case, table file is writing a file to the card at the top of each hourly interval. I have set the maximum files parameter of table file to -1. Which means there is no maximum number of files that can be written to the card. Instead, new files will continue to be written until the card is filled. Once the card is full, new files will overwrite to the oldest files. Review the previous video and the CR Basic help for details on when it's best to use cardOut or table file. How much time is required between card swaps is dependent on the number of records stored and how quickly those records are stored. Some programs may store only a few records on a slow time interval, and it may take years to fill up a card. This does not mean I should wait that long to check the card. Low power or lightning strikes or unexpected program issues may lead to write errors, so it's best to monitor card status often. If there's a communications link between a computer and the data logger, it is a good idea to monitor the card status remotely. Card status is reported in the status table. The status will show card OK if there are no card errors. If there is a card error, an error message is shown. Card status can also be monitored within the program using a table name, field name, syntax. In this case, the table is status and the field is status card, so the syntax is status.cardStatus. In this example code, I've declared a variable named statusCard as type string to hold the results of a status card status. The variable must be type string, or the numerical value of card OK will be returned. Whenever a card is removed from the data logger while a program is running, always start by pressing the eject button and wait for the ACT LED to turn green. Pressing the eject button triggers the data logger to flush data from the CPU buffer to the card. Depending on the amount of data in the buffer, the LED may turn green almost immediately, or I may see the LED turn red for a few seconds while data is transferred from the CPU buffer to the card. The red LED indicates that a data write is occurring. Once the LED turns green, it is safe to remove the card. If the card is not removed after 15 seconds, data will continue to be written normally, as if the eject button were not pressed. Once a card is removed, it must be replaced before the CPU memory for a data table rings or data will be overwritten and lost. For example, if a data table in CPU memory has a capacity for about 45 minutes of data, the card exchange must take place any time before the 45 minutes expire. If the exchange is delayed by an additional 5 minutes, 5 minutes of data at the beginning of the last 45-minute interval will be overwritten in CPU memory and lost before the new card is inserted. The ACT LED will turn orange if no card is present, and the CPU memory has wrapped so data in the CPU buffer is being overwritten without being stored to the card. In the next video, I will demonstrate how to transfer data from the card to a computer and how to use card convert to convert the data from binary to ASCII.